Brandon from the New Fury. We're here at Epic Problems, or as I just always call it, Transitions. I'm here with Eric Hammerfield, who just played this set. How are you guys doing?
Good, I'm well.
For those who don't know who are, can you introduce yourself? What are you doing in the band?
My name is Blake, and I play guitar.
I'm Corbin, and I do vocals.
Josh,
hey, Josh.
And I am Dylan, and I play guitar as well.
Alright, you guys just played your set. You went on second. Like, how was this show for you playing with some of the best bands in the world?
I think it was really good. We got a really nice reaction from the crowd.
Lyrically, the whole song, it's actually Eyesight. It's like a story. Eyesight comes first, and then Pretentious Prayer comes second. Eyesight is like you're giving in to negativity. Pretentious Prayer then comes like number two. It follows behind Eyesight, as opposed to. And Pretentious Prayer is basically you basically fell into a big negative, basically like a loophole. And then you find yourself, like your real self, within that like negativity. So, say like you're a goody two-shoes or whatever, being raised you know, very well by great parents and everything, you fall into bad, a bad situation or something, and then Pretentious Prayer is basically realizing that you are a different person than what you were originally basically, and that negativity that is that I think basically described in the song is basically the devil. It's August 6th at Uncle Luke's in Orlando. It should be huge. First time I played there went well, but it was with a lot of like hardcore bands that were touring. This one's more of a metal, like our genre type show, so hopefully it turns out great. I have really high expectations for it. I'm sure they'll be pretty stoked for that show. Yeah, so I'm a big fan of music. They're a great band. I'm pretty stoked for the entire show.
Yeah, that's true.
be a Wild
Band. Yeah, Warped Tour, my first year was 07. The Warped Tour 07 was like
my favorite thing.
Really? Yeah. 07 and on, dude. I love Warped Tour. Because it was like Andrew WK,
all kinds of great bands, too, Bad Religion.
Bad
Religion was like,
yeah, right? It was good.
What's the biggest of that? Anyway, what are some of your favorite music releases from this year?
The new Spring New Record. The new Plot New Record. New Within the Room?
Yeah. New Within the Room is doing a lot of it. What else?
New Attila
was one of the last ones.
I haven't listened to it, but I hear a lot of people.
Honestly, I didn't think it was that bad.
Once we're all past this, they got a video banned on YouTube. But,
I didn't think it was that bad musically. Not to make fun of it, but it wasn't something I thought they should have done.
Yeah.
Good
fun. Everyone has a dark passenger within them and sort of roll with the punches and put up with everyone's crap and
end up beating lots of through that. And so it's like, you know, I really want people to realize that, like, everything that can happen is capable completely by themselves. And I want people to realize that self-help, all that is, everyone is completely capable of by themselves, and they don't need any outside source, any outside help. Whatever it may be to you, whether it may be God or like winning the lottery or something like that, I want people to realize that greatness exists within our own potential.
Exactly. Yeah. No matter if you're in a crap situation or not, there's always hope.
That's right. Like, there's a dark side to everything, but at the same time, there's also a silver lining.
There you go. That's, yeah, exactly what I'm saying. All right. Last question. Where do you usually get your lyrical inspiration?
That was really good. It was kind of like Shutter Island, but like more horror band.
That movie blew my mind.
That's
a great movie. Anything zombie, I think, is a great movie. It doesn't matter if it's a bad zombie movie, it's still a great movie.
So, if you actually got
the Nazi zombie.
Yeah, right.
I mean,
it could go on and on and on.
The end is really funny.